We've expected something from the system that it wasn't able to deliver. Whether the problem is in our expectations or in the system is, of course, a question. I think our problem here was that we had a black and white view of market capitalism. We expected it to be perfect, faultless. And now it is beyond measure clear that it isn't faultless. And while one can be critical, very critical of the system, it has many mistakes. It's still, I don't think it, the fault was such as to throw the whole system away and to try and to look for something completely new. I think we need to try to improve the system and work with it. And you know, you have to be critical towards something that that you live in and that you are a part of. So yes, absolutely. I think the system is changing. You can see it in Europe. We're coming closer together. We're not fighting for the first time in history. There is a huge crisis, which is financial and also economic. But we did not go into war. On the contrary, we're kind of coming together and we're helping each other out. So I think that's good news. That's one change. And the second change, we understand that markets cannot do it themselves. There need to be sort of limits and corrections. And as how exactly they should look like, this is the debate that we're undergoing. I think that return to a gold standard would be something that wouldn't be good, because the problem with gold standard is you have to have the amount of new gold, newly discovered gold, should be pretty much the same like the GDP growth. In the year, if we only have a constant number of gold and our economies become richer, then that would lead to prices falling down. So the advantage of gold standard is fixed exchange rates, and that's something we can do with euro, and that's good enough. But it's not good to have your hands tied completely and not be able to you know, provide enough liquidity for the markets. We have had very good history with inflation. We haven't misused that too much in the last generation or two. So I would be much more willing to say we should do something very dramatic with our fiscal policy, but not with our monetary policy necessarily.